So, as you've seen, no, evolve over a period of time. Sensor technology will deep dive. I see majority of you people are not from cinematography or editing and VFX. But from these branches, if you are from direction and screenwriting, the technology might not be for you, but learning is good business. Learning anything is basically good for you. And R3D, what is R3D? We'll talk about R3D. R3D is a file format. Format in which you get your red footage. Like if you shoot with 700D, you'll get .mov file. Like that, if you shoot with red cameras, you'll get R3D file. Red code ROM, we're talking about what is red code ROM. And there is something called DSMC, digital still and motion capture. With the same camera, you can capture motion and stills as well, because these cameras are beasts in terms of resolution. They are very big in terms of resolution. So if you pull one frame grab from a 96 frames per second video, I shot a video at 96 frames per second in an 8K camera, and I pull a frame grab from it, it will be around 40 megapixels, 35-40 megapixels. So even for, you know, printing and for vinyls and all, it's good enough. That's the concept of DSMC, we'll go there. We'll talk about OLPF, optical low pass filter. What is optical low pass filter and what is the role of it? We'll talk about black calibration, and we'll have a hands-on experience of it. We'll be having, you know, cameras, your cameras ready. And we'll go to touch them, the menus, what is what. If you have any questions, we'll talk about it. That will be the last thing. Conversation, I'm expecting a lot of conversation from you guys, enthusiasm, discussion, conversation. Language shouldn't be a barrier, because there are people who can translate. If you cannot completely understand, you can ask your teacher or someone who can understand English. You can talk. Language is not a barrier if you really want to learn. That's what I believe it is. Okay? Right. So the evolution of RED. We actually, in terms of cinema camera companies and still photography camera companies, RED is a very, very new camera. Like, kid. Okay, before I start, I think you guys joined. I want you to introduce yourself. Okay. What's your branch or what's your, what are you studying? And sit. And third thing, your experience on camera. I mean, if you don't have cameras, that's fine.
Basically.
Anything, DSLR, what cameras have you used?
ADV.
You operate it?
Okay. ADV and then, is it
1-5 mark? Photography knowledge.
Good
enough.
That's fine. What cameras have you get to use hands on?
One
DSLR. What DSLR?
Canon
780. Okay. Okay. Your name? What's your branch? And if you have any expertise or prior experience with cameras, what cameras have you?
Yes,
what kind of DSLR? That's fine. There are like thousands of DSLRs. I just want to know that. And people who just came right now. Okay. Louder, louder. No, don't get up, louder. Sit and speak louder.
Deepak, sir. VFX. Action.
Direction. Right. You don't have any experience with cameras? Okay.
Avinash, VFX.
And what footage you worked on, you're working on? Which era? When I speak, is it audible to you? Talking, is it audible to you? If you're not audible to me. So be loud and talk. Basically, I'm talking about the evolution of camera company as a company. If you take bigger camera company from older camera company, bigger is might not be the right word of choice. If you take companies like Arri, if you take companies like Sony, if you take companies like Canon, Nikon, all these are like they are there in the industry, be it stills or be it cinema or video, from like ages. Arri is a 100-year-old company. Even Sony, Canon, they have a very, you know, long history of making cameras. We are, compared to them, we are a new kid in the block. We are just 12-year-old company, 12-13-year-old company. But Red, as a company, aggressively pushed the boundaries. That is the reason why we are in the position where we are. We constantly push the industry, we constantly driven the industry. Red as a company, I mean, if you talk about 2005 and 6, in the second day, someone called Jim Chandler. That guy was a camera enthusiast, but besides being enthusiast, he was an avid, he used to own a company called Oakley. Oakley manufactures sunglasses. He doesn't have any manufacturing experience with cameras, but he used mini cameras all his life. He is one of the biggest connoisseurs of cameras. He owns every camera that is manufactured by any company. So he is that sort of guy. He used to own cameras, he used to shoot in his free time, that sort of thing. Back in 2005, mid-2000s, what used to happen is Sony and Panasonic, they used to sell 1080p, 1080i cameras for like, in Indian currency, 1 CR plus, okay? They used to sell cameras for like very high cost, which used to have specs of, you know, very low resolutions, very low. The thing is, it works in a weird way. There will be technology with every company and there will be marketing. Marketing is the one which will decide when to release what technology. If a camera company is stuck to and releasing only 1080p full HD cameras, that doesn't mean they don't have 4K or 8K cameras. It just means